And in the United States, we're reckoning with centuries of racial injustice and rampant inequality, while a deep partisan divide threatens our ability to find any meaningful solutions. And hanging over it all, both in terms of the scale of the problem and the potential it holds in solving many of society's biggest problems, is climate change, which is an existential threat to the planet and humanity, and why we're gathered here today. Now, the good news is I've seen firsthand that it is possible to make progress when you turn toward the problem, even when it seems impossible. Here's an example. More than 2 billion people don't have access to safe drinkable water, and as a result, over 1 million people die per year. But the problem is actually much bigger than that, because it's also robbing millions of women and children of their future potential, their true potential. After all, if you have to walk multiple hours each way to collect water for your family, how are you going to school? How are you preparing yourself for a better future? And with climate change, water sources are drying up, and those walks are getting longer and sometimes simply futile. Now, I've been on those walks with kids who should have been in school. And through the organizations I co-founded, Water.org and Water Equity, we've empowered more than 30 million people with safe water or sanitation. And that progress could be wiped out if we don't get serious about climate change. The scale of the climate crisis is just staggering. But you can't let that be an excuse for doing nothing. So to fight climate change, we can't be overwhelmed by the seeming impossibility of the task at hand. We don't have the luxury of ignoring it if we want to build a better future for our children and grandchildren. And the potential impact of making even incremental progress cannot be understated. Every decision we make now, every action we take, and every commitment we make has an impact on the world that the next generations are going to inherit. And it is incumbent upon all of us to ensure that it's as good of a world as the one we enjoyed.